I guess the only thing.
If I go over to 6 and 7 or soybean, 10.
You need that cat loader of Siriuses.
What are you planning right now? You're planning soybean?
Yeah, you said it was soybeans, right?
Yeah. I'm going to do sunflower, actually. So when you're done with 11, go to 6 and 7. And I'm going to do 10 and 15. The sunflower.
All 10 and 15 are going to be sunflower?
And 17. But we can probably do that together.
What do you got for milo fields?
I think I only did one. I did 18. To milo.
Just one field of milo?
Yeah.
See how it looks.
See how it goes, see what it's like. I'd rather do sunflower just because I think it's going to be more profitable.
I think it'd be nice to get like if we're playing on this in the month of May or like the breast cancer month, to get that pink kitty from Julian.
I'm thinking of doing a pink and a black.
The black. There's a pink one in Jackson, Minnesota at the plant that they did for breast cancer, and they had a bunch of women come in and sign that thing in. Yeah.
The nice thing is, you know how they have the T8 New Holland, or like the Draper, how it can be, it has like parts that you can turn on and off, or like visible or not visible. So I can have the black body and the pink body already in.
Yep.
And then just change the XML so it doesn't waste so much memory on a whole separate model.
And to do it like they have the paint feature for like pickups and semis, but just have
No. Kind of like what Vertex Design did with the Volvo and JCB.
Oh.
It's only one shape, but you have two XML, or like how the case in the New Holland 45 foot drapers are. There's only one shape, but there's two XMLs.
Oh. That'll be nice.
So we can have one actual like i3D. User entered your channel. But three different scripts. Who's this guy?
The fat man.
The fat man? That's you, Jake.
Wow.
No, it's okay. Captain Crippled.
There you go. Captain Crippled sounds better than Fat Man.
You can dodge a wrench, you can dodge ball.
I just can't dodge myself.
10 sunflower.
I thought you were going to do 6 and 7.
No, you're going to, because you got beans. I got sunflower.
You're dick.
Whatever, you're going to be done with that in 2 seconds anyways.
I got the south side of 11 to do.
Dude, it's not big at all.
No, but it's not straight.
He's being a sandy vagina.
Really? You're just mad that I left you that little corner piece on the team.
I wanted to plant sunflower. Sunflower child. You know, I was confused because when I was putting it in map, it kind of like turns into like a dark brown when you're at the harvest stage.
That's sunflower for you.
Really? I didn't know that.
Yeah,
I was expecting.
Yeah.
It looks like shit.
It does. It looks like it's totally dead and dark.
Yeah. So I thought I screwed up when I was putting it in the map. I'm like, that ain't right. I screwed up.
No, you're right. Sunflower is the death of confidence.
Really?
I don't care.
Yeah. That's the reason a lot of guys carry chains. They tie a big log chain around their axle and let it drag on the ground to get rid of all the static, because Sunflower in a heartbeat will start your combine on fire.
Really?
Oh, yeah. Almost
as beans are just about to die.
But Sunflower's a lot drier, and Sunflower will. I've heard a lot more with Sunflower than I have with beans lately.
That's because people are figuring out you gotta lift your head up with beans, and you just can't hit a rock. And you gotta leave it.
Well, they just need to hire a guy like you to roll the field, and then they don't have to worry about it.
What do you mean? You are paying him. You will be paying him to roll the field pretty soon.
Yeah. We never actually rolled our beans. Or no, we didn't roll our beans.
I was gonna say, that's the main reason people buy rollers is to do their bean drill.
You roll before you plant, though, right?
No, you roll after you plant.
Well, I thought they were a little bit more picky about depth, seed depth.
No, it's mine.
Which you are picky about your seed depth. What you're really doing when you roll it is you're just closing the furrow.
Alright. So, are there people that roll... Like, there's two different theories, right? One is for better seed depth, and then one is for seed contact after?
No, it's basically seed contact and pushing the rock back in the ground so
you can
hit it with the bean header.
So you can just leave your draper on the ground?
Yeah.
You gotta watch the rock. You see a rock, you lift your head up. That's one thing that'll start and catch you too.
Or go through the beater out and cause a lot of damage.
Yeah, that's really cool. Trying to pry a rock out of the house. Or a pheasant.
You guys want some jerky? With your cord?
I seen a guy put a big buck through the Lexion. Didn't work out so well.
Are you telling me the Lexion couldn't chew up that deer? Those things eat corn and deer should be no problem.
They don't like them. I've seen deer go through a silage chopper and completely destroy the inside of the silage chopper.
Yeah.
I've seen a lot of things go through a chopper. Not a deer. I've seen rabbits.
I was spraying a field and I seen a deer come out of the slough, hit my tire as it was going across the field, bounced off of it, took off back into the slough.
People around Wisconsin, like north of Wisconsin, have issues with bears in their fields. Bear dens, whatever.
A bear den? Try a badger.
Yeah, we get badger.
Yeah, badgers too.
Badgers are bad. They're cocksuckers.
They'll come out of nowhere. You'll be cruising at 20 and the next thing you know,
badger will. Whoa! Everything is everywhere.
Are you gonna set that field roller up for the same way you set up your crumblers or conditioners?
I'm gonna script it so it puts down water.
Yeah, just like your conditioner.
Yeah.
You might want to find a tractor that can stabilize it if you're going to have some of us run that. Because I don't think many kiddies can handle chisel plow ground at 20 miles an hour.
Can I handle what?
Plowed.
Plowed.
You know,
do it like 20.
What?
What are you doing at 20 miles an hour?
Going on the roller.
Wow.
What? We got shit to do.
Wow.
just waiting to get video of you going hauling through town with a load of grain and doubles. That is gonna be funny.
Just for somebody who's got experience with a roller, 90-foot rollers.
Yeah, we're not talking 90.
20 mile an hour.
That's like nitrous on a tractor.
That's really high gear. Across the field.
And your point is?
This is Jake we're talking about.
Really?
It's about 5 mile an hour faster than that.
You're the one that said if Mini Kitty can't handle the DN at 20, you're gonna be pissed off at Giants.
What are you saying?
What was that comment you made in the group chat about if Kitty can't do it at 20 mile an hour, I'm gonna be mad?
I don't know.
Hopefully Giants doesn't screw Mini Kitty and it can run as fast as a...
Mini Kitty is gonna be amazing.
Get a minute. We push those New Hollands in that DN pretty fast across the
field. Yeah. I was giving it the whole time.
How fast are you guys going? 24, 25?
As like, fast as we can go. Well, that's what it's spec'd at the broadcast.
Yeah. Well, Mike, the dual don't follow GPS very well. Yeah. Or no, the ATI don't follow it at that
time. Yeah, well, neither does the dual.
What do you mean? I ran the dual on GPS at that speed.
Really?
Yeah, you just gotta be damn sure you're on top of your line when you hit start. Otherwise, it's gonna go, hey! Just like every once in a while when you hit your button to set your GPS or your auto steer on a interrogator, and you want it to go straight, it's gonna take right. A hard right. Done that coming out of a corner, or coming out of my one headlight and going into the other one, and I set my GPS doing like 17, all of a sudden it took a hard.
You know what, I think Mike was running 3 chisel plows in this field.
Well, you can unfollow me.
I know, but it's not a very big field. But
it's Mike, he's from Canada.
Hey.
Hey.
He's happy that he gets to play with a small field. Well, no, I think he said he has a lot of small fields. He's gonna be mad that you didn't put rentals in. Yeah.
Look what I'm doing, eh? Running 3 at a time, eh?
Oh, could you imagine if we were talking about him and he come in the chat drunk? Canada is no different than America. Yeah, it is.
What's up north, eh?
You know, I always thought this would be funny if you put a hidden button or like a hidden texture in that Kinsey. Like if you had the spout out and you hit a certain button, all of a sudden it pops out like an American or a Canadian flag.
A huge Canadian flag waving on the pipe. Holy shit, that's a great idea. It's invisible and then when you press B or X, it like pops out. Oh my god. He would literally probably lose his shit.
He'd probably think it's funny, but he'd call me dance.
That would be the greatest.
Too bad they don't get dirty. I'd like to see him on like.
Yeah, I tried to make the flake shader work with the dirt shader, and it doesn't really work.
Like you did in 13.
With the on the combines.
Yeah.
Goes to unload pipe, huge ass Canadian flag just waving.
Put it as like X, since I don't think the cart has an X feature. Just like hit X, Mike, just do it. Dicks.
This is a huge like 10-foot flag hanging off the pipe.
Don't even have to be a big one, just like a small one. Like some of, I've seen some carts have American flags on the pipe.
No, I'd want it big so when you see him driving across the field with it unfolded, the flag's out. It's going like 20 across the field with this huge Canadian flag. And you can't turn it off because you have to unfold the pipe, you know, if you have it scripted so it's always out when the pipe's unfolded.
Guys, I can't see into the tree, they're going north. Why not? There's a big ass Canadian flag in the way.
I think that would be great.
I think it'd be funny. He'd probably laugh and then, these are dicks. It's like Jake putting my face in a Canadian mountain guy. That was
yo, hoser!
I posted that and I was like waiting for somebody to look at it and Colby goes, oh, this is great. Mike goes, you got to be shitting me. Like, oh, no, buddy. I've got time. I'm bored in the elevator.
You've got to be shitting
me. Well, I got the app on my phone so I can like make my own. So I can like Google just...
I remember watching your video and I just hear your gay ass phone go off.
The screaming goat?
Fucking
screaming goat.
Screaming
goat in the
what the hell is that?
You ever seen that video of that goat screaming on YouTube?
Nope.
Can't say that I have.
It used to be a flirting whistle. And then you'd walk through the mall and like a big flirt whistle would go off and all these girls would just turn and I'd keep a straight face walking, my other buddy just sitting here laughing.
You gotta put the fart machine sound. Like Larry, what is it, Larry the Cable Guy is trying to like buy a mattress. They got that fart machine going on the whole time.
I have a buddy named Will. When it called, it goes, Chocolate Factory is calling. Have you ordered a Oompa Loompa?
Chocolate Factory.
Because in the name, Willy Wonka from the Chocolate Factory, like if he doesn't answer our phone call, me and my other trucking buddy will just sit there and call and just pay the voicemail. You want to order two Oompa Loompas?
We'll take 2.5. This is a no-till field. Interesting.
Oh, 10 East, yeah.
I wonder what kind of residue comes with sunflower.
Black, like corn. Because they combine it just like corn, don't they, bro? For a bunch of them. You might have to raise
them. No.
What?
No. I don't eat meat.
I thought, I've seen guys use corn headers.
Yeah, but most kids use bean or the chop.
Well, we're using corn headers. Yeah, I'd probably put it in the line to have like the stalk of the sunflower hang up like you do the corn.
It's gonna be trial and error to get that tuned in, I think.
I like how a lot of people go, how do you get your corn stalks to do that? And I go, in the XML, but I think that was the greatest idea we ever did.
And it looks good with the wheel lanes.
I know, I was kind of sad to till up 17 because it looked so good.
Dude, it looked way good. So did 15 when I was doing 29. 15 looked mint with all that residue.
I should go down to that farm to see how you lighten that out to fit those doubles in there. The scales are nice. No DOT.
We have a permit.
I was gonna say, the cripple, he knows how to chili dip.
Knows how to what?
And we call it dodging scales, we call it chili dipping.
Chili dipping.
Best in the 300-mile area, I'd not get it out of every scale.
He hates DOT.
Is that a fat joke?
No.
Yeah, there's a lot of kind of stupid things like that.
Better?
I've come.
We're coming to fucking 96.
Yeah, I've come in with a 36-foot trailer.
I'm burning through a lot more sea than you are with the sunflower.
Yeah, doesn't sunflower use more sea, Stubby?
Sunflower?
Yeah.
It uses, it's like twice the rate of soybeans on this map right now.
Yeah, you know that's crap thick.
You know, you have somebody in here that could be your seed biatch.
Seed biatch. I'm gonna need a seed biatch.
But, that seed biatch in this chat doesn't like the chef.
What?
Get a Chevy.
No, Jake's gonna buy me a nice new Chevy.
I should. When I get my acre bonus this spring, I will. I think, and hopefully, it'll be $7,000-$8,000.
Nice.
Get around a 44-30 all summer, so I can send you a shit ton of pictures if you want it.
44-30. That's cool.
I know, they got the 40 series out. Thing's only like 2 years old. In really great shape still, surprisingly.
This was a lot.
Yeah.
There goes Jake.
Call me. How are you coming on that 100-acre field? I'm done. Bullshit. Oh yeah. Not dusty out today, rolling nice, he planted it straight. I sprayed it at like 18. Seriously? Oh yeah. How much did you hit? Not much. Why don't you come out and look? I don't know. I kind of like those Patriots. They're really nice and quiet. They're a lot of those cabs because they're a quad track kit.
Yeah. They look sharp from the profile.
And then they got the Harley bars. Those are the biggest, best feature I think I've ever seen.
Jake's all about cab comfort.
Yeah, they got, well,
he needs room to take his shoes off.
Oh, I do take my shoes off in my Sprinter. But at the bottom of, like, where the brake is on the side there, on the side of the steering console, there's two bars that come out so you can kick your feet up on them and relax. It's great.
I'm just, gotta imagine how fast we have General Deere Sprinters that gun rounds.
Yeah. My company won't let me do it.
It's always fun.
We cannot have guns in company property.
Conceal and carry.
Can't do that. It's against EDM policy. We can have them in our vehicles, but we have to lock our vehicles.
Probably the smartest thing.
South Dakota is the easiest state to probably go get your concealed carry. It's like $15. You go down to the sheriff's department, fill out your background check, and they give you a temporary, and it's like $15, and a week later you got your concealed.
Wait up. You go in, eat later, you get temporary, a month later, you get actual.
Yeah, well, it's been 2 years since I did mine. And they're good for 5 years, so it's great.
I just renewed mine this last week.
Yeah, wasn't that the same day you crippled yourself?
No. 2 weeks before. 3 weeks before. No, I went and bought tires and windshields and I could end my remote start and I bought my plates for me.
Yeah, I ate our new plates. Now we look like Iwegians.
Pretty much.
We're gonna put Mount Rushmore on the plate.
I'm at 50%. on this field already.
Yeah, it's like you're planting wheat. Potato that really goes through on this field.
Yeah, well, I mean, this is a higher seed population, and it's about the same yield. It's a little bit lower, but the price per bushel is...
Are you just going to jump to the truck and fill the J&M?
Probably going to have to.
Probably be easier than driving all the way over there.
I mean, the truck and the tender is already over there, so probably run this down and run over there and get it, because you'll probably... I don't think you'll need a refill. You'll probably do 6 and 7 and finish 11 before you need to.
It'll be close. I might just go refill when I get done with 11 since I'm on this side of the area.
Did you get that map you told me to go get the other night?
Glenbar?
So you can do 120 acres on a tank. Corn.
Everything seems like it needs to die around.
On Glenbar, I kind of noticed that if you drive really fast.
What happened?
Oh, on Glenbar, like, driving that T9, like, if you're driving it straight with the cruise on, all of a sudden you'll just start to see the front of the tractor slide to the right or slide to the left.
Really?
Yeah. Yours used to do it a while ago, but you did something to your map and fixed it, because you can almost drive straight down your map and not have an issue. Go to American Farming Photography. They have the Idaho one, which I heard is pretty good if you want a new map. Figured if you wanted to harvest for a week without leaving the one field. Who knows, as fast as we're knocking out planting, might not be very long until we're to harvest already.
I must want to, like, write off the canola and just keep doing DN work, you know?
What do you mean, write off?
Plant something else, like milo or more sunflower or more soybean or...
I'm game for it. I'm game for more milo because canola does not yield very much and uses a crap ton like sunflower.
I just don't want to use the shitty air seeders.
The John Deere air seeders aren't bad.
Canola, or not canola, milo. What are you actually doing with it?
Combine. Any corn place? Yep, New Gen takes milo.
That's what I was wondering. Take it anywhere.
Yeah. You take milo anywhere, you can sell sunflower at the co-op, sell rye at Budweiser. I'd say plant a field of rye.
Well, that's like... That's like planting oats, really.
Oh, dude. So it's kind of the same texture.
It's pretty much the same texture. It's a little bit lighter. Same. It's shitty. I mean, good yield, shitty price.
Yeah, canola's got a really good price, but it's got a shitty yield.
We did okay, I think.
Yeah, but we also planted. Crapped on a canola that time.
We're getting like 60 bushel on acre.
Didn't we do 44 and we barely got like 3 or 2 semi loads off 44?
Yeah.
Grump is gonna be moving when we do corn. Mike is gonna be moving when we do corn. If you get those 216 rows.
Well, if you have a guy on truck, dedicated on truck, it won't be that bad.
No, I think it'll actually be great. It's just if we get drunk one night and decide to play games with Mike and go two different directions.
Yeah, if you throw off the momentum and it's... you're gonna be sitting there waiting for Mike.
I could just see it in his accent. Alright, you guys, this isn't funny.
Hey, where are you going?
Mike! Service me.
If you guys would stick together, we wouldn't have this issue.
No, he needs a bigger tractor, and the we got the trailers now, so...
Oh, yeah.
Should be pretty easy to keep up. He'll have room. He'll have room to unload his cart. That's usually the problem with that, is you run out of room to dump it. And then you're running around with a 3/4 full cart trying to keep up.
Yeah, by the way.
Had the same setup as what Jake one time would be able to do.
Yeah, you're going to be
1,500 bushel grain carts. It would keep up with them. Real. And we were running two kind of on beside each other.
I think we'll keep up. We've done it before with 700 bushel corn in game and kept up.
It's not that difficult to keep up as long as you have a bin extension.
You'll be pulling 236 foots, and they pull a mean.
Want to pop over your flips over?
36 won't flip over. They actually pull better than the pup does.
The 43 foot and 18 foot, I wasn't really liking that, how it was handling.
Yeah, they don't handle for shit in real life.
It like puts too much weight on the truck, and you don't have enough braking power.
Yeah, sure. I like the tandem 36s.
Triple.
Yeah, tandem 36s work great.
Gotta go A&O style.
Yeah, but you're not getting a Pete, so.
What?
You're getting a cat.
People are so over fucking ridiculous. I only like driving ovals.
You can't for kennels, so. I think a cat is gonna be made from the truck.
Hopefully make a cute behind, but.
It's only what, 2.3 million? Yeah, or is it more than that?
It's a polybomb, but it only affects it when you first buy, like, once it loads, it doesn't really lag at all.
Yeah, because the map has done a lot better now since I've actually driven around it.
Because 15 is very different than 13, it caches. So it, like, it's kind of like your GPU caches the memory. So once it's, like, syncs and caches, it's... that no longer really affects your game play at all.
Alright, you might be right. I might be able to get 6 done before I need to film.
Yeah, easily. You should be able to.
I gotta go deal with all the small crap over here. This is always a fun field to harvest. I think everybody's gonna know what to do when they see the new crops on the map. You know what commons are gonna come out now.
I have wind chaser, but don't have those crops.
I still can't mow alfalfa. I can't harvest soybean.
Thank heaven for the 1.3 batch.
God. It was 1.2.
Oh, no.
That's what messed the whole map up way back when.
fall. We were just on version 1.3.
Oh yeah, this is 5.1 right now.
Yep. Yep.
I'm just gonna knock out this little section and I have enough.
Oh man, he even bought a blue seat tender.
Yeah, I've never used the blue one.
I usually use the gray.
Same. Probably looks kind of funny with the red truck. I think next truck I get is going to be white.
I'd say do silver like the trucks.
Silver?
Aren't truck cameras kind of a silverish white?
Like, well, it kind of looks like a silver because of the glossy cube map.
Yeah, that color meshes with your black train is almost perfect.
Yeah.
How much is a dumb thing? Holy crap.
It's 10 or 15,000. Not enough to fill up a planter?
Yeah, it is.
Was it hold 15,000?
Oh, yeah.
Alright, so a little bit more than a...
Now just not to wreck the pickup on the way over there.
Some pretty nice lighting on the map right now, getting some nice footage.
Yeah. My internet's gonna hate me at about 11 o'clock or whenever I decide to get off and start uploading.
Yeah, it's
videos.
Gonna be uploading all night and then into tomorrow, so. That's what I do. I usually play, get a couple hours of videos, and then I just upload and.
Couple, we're gonna have about four or five hours when I get done with it.
Yeah, so.
Oh boy, this truck is screaming.
I need to fix the sounds on that. I don't like the sounds on that at all.
Oh boy. Which one are you going to next? 15?
Yeah, I was gonna go to 15.
Besides, the pipe needs to almost like point up in the sky a little bit more.
The what?
Like the unload pipe could be raised up at the top a little bit so it's higher off the ground. Cause you almost gotta drop the planter.
Don't you usually drop the planter when you're filling it?
No. Well, you can.
Drop it from the floor.
Put it to the ground.
Yeah. It's just a simple mod. I mean, you can, like, mouse control it and stuff if you want.
But it works.
I don't know if it's set up. I mean, still have Abel's big seat tender. Never used it, but I used it once, I think, on Westbridge to to see what it was.
It'd be fun to take the tanks off the front and actually put that, see, put like two seed tenders on it.
Or just building a really big semi seed tender trailer, like what you guys use.
No, the pair.
Wow. Yeah, actually, out west, there's the old conveyor and others.
Yeah, like people in the back. I don't know if he's got the description to work yet.
Yeah, you just pretty much have a spot where you can dump with the fire that you need with the pickup. Drive your summer over, drive over a bit.
Ugh, so many short phones.
That's what we did, so you can do some fertilizer and copper.
Yeah, we're just putting seed down. You missed all the fun with the DN work.
So heartbroken.
Well, don't worry, you'll get to join it.
Finished.
I think you should almost rent him the 870 Colo and let him go to town like we used to have to do.
You need an urn.
How much time do you actually think we spent with those nice Colos actually doing all that? Week and a half to do that one season?
It took forever.
Kids, tillage, the most fun part of the game. No.
What's funny?
Well, it's fun, I mean, but, like, it's a lot of work.
It's a lot of work when you're only covering, like, 6 meters a pass.
But they look damn nice.
It would have been nice if he would have went with a 13 shank. He'd still be using it.
Yeah. Now somebody wants to do a 27-30.
It's gonna be sweet. That thing is huge. It is literally like a factory out on the field. Like, there's like so much going on with that tillage tool.
Yeah, that T9 thing. Well, good thing I got 700 horsepower.
So I'm gonna need every little pony. You look at the 9620R and the thing is just screaming, pulling it.
Well, so far we got to do two fields together.
Oh, I'm gonna probably call it a night here.
Okay.
And then maybe we can like do it again tomorrow or something.
Yeah, we can. I'll probably call it a night after finishing 11 here. Get off the server. Seed tender's over there if you want to refill, then I'll just go refill before I get off.
Yeah,
that way it's full for tomorrow.
Backing up to it right now, so.
Going through my Amazon library to see what I got for video.